The first video we're seeing of the little boy held captive in a bunker for nearly a week, a nation holding its breath, and now a mother holding her little boy again. Tonight, ABC anchor David Muir is just back from Alabama with exclusive pictures, and you met with the family, David, and how is he doing?
You know what? Ethan is smiling wide, Diane, and you'll see it for yourself right here tonight. So was his mom, his brother, his entire family. Grateful for that rescue, grateful they were able to throw him that birthday party, that team getting him out just before he turned six.
Tonight, an ABC News exclusive. This is Ethan, that boy held in the bunker, now home with his mother, his family, now smiling again. The family telling us they hoped we would show America their little boy is back. And tonight, for the first time, the images from Ethan's birthday party this week. He turned six. Taken captive just days before his birthday, the entire town had hoped and prayed for this party. And they held it. His family, his friends, and the heroes, the team that saved him. The FBI agent made the call to move in.
Approximately 3:12 this afternoon, FBI agents safely recovered the child who has been held hostage for nearly a week.
For the first time, Ethan's immediate family is talking. His older brother telling us how difficult it was for his mother, not able to hug the boy who loved to be hugged, who loved to be tucked in at night.
It was very hard not to be able to physically touch him and hug him and, you know, really be there for him.
The family telling me they knew little about the minute-by-minute surveillance of that bunker, about the crying for his mother, about the rare moments of joy negotiators could hear when those toys were passed through that hatch on the top of the bunker. Just today, aerial pictures, investigators digging all around that bunker as they continue to sort through the evidence. We learned that every night the family would depend on that team, waiting for a text message when Ethan would go to sleep.
We didn't know when. At times he was asleep, and that was normally around 9 o'clock at night.
So they would at least be able to tell you he's gone to bed for the night?
Yes.
Was that at least some comfort?
That was actually a lot of comfort, where I could actually go lay my head down.
But as the hours turned to days and Ethan's mother grew more nervous, ABC News has learned that there was a moment when the FBI special agent in charge grew very nervous too, telling us he suddenly knew they'd run out of time to negotiate.
How close do you think his mother was to losing Ethan?
I thought he was going to die. We all thought he was going to die.
He made it clear he was going to harm Ethan?
He made it very clear that he was going to execute his plan, and that was the day.
He was chillingly candid as we spoke one-on-one with the special agent in charge. Tonight on 2020, you'll hear what it was that led to that call to move in and quickly. Diane, they fooled the gunman into coming closer to the hatch at the top of the bunker, and we'll tell you what they did to trick him at just the right time.
And has Ethan spoken about that yet?
That's what I asked the family, too. They said he's not said a word about the bunker or the man. We do know he was so cheerful at that birthday party. There's been one other trip, Diane, to Toys R Us.